This video explains system audit of mechanical utilities. The first part of this video is pump. A device which expends the mechanical energy to raise, transport or compress the fluid is generally known as pump. Also, it transports the slurries sometimes. Based on the application, requirement and operating principle, the pumps can be classified into two types. One is dynamic, another one is displacement type. Dynamic further classified into centrifugal pump, special effect pump and submersible pump, whereas displacement pump generally known as reciprocating pump. The major parts of the centrifugal pump are impeller and diffuser. Water enters the center of the impeller and exits the impeller with the help of centrifugal force. Whenever the water leaves from the impeller, it creates the low pressure so that the more water has to flow into the eye. Also, the velocity is developed as the water flows through the impeller, which is spinning at very high speed with the help of some electrical motor. There are few important hints to note in the centrifugal pump. Whenever the quantity of the water requirement is getting more, automatically energy consumption will become more. Also, if the depth of the water is more, the flow from the pump will be reducing. Whereas, the pump against increasing pressure always results in reducing in the performance. Next, we are going to see about reciprocating pump. It is a positive displacement pump where certain volume of liquid is collected in enclosed volume and discharged using the pressure to the required application. The main components of reciprocating pumps are suction pipe and valve, delivery pipe and valve, cylinder, piston and piston rod, crank and connecting rod, strainer, air vessel. When the power source is connected to the crank will start rotating and connecting rod also displaced along with the crank. Due to this mechanical action, the vacuum created inside the cylinder, so that whenever the crank moves, the suction valve opens whereas delivery valves get closed. Also, vice versa, the delivery valve opens and the suction valve get closed. Due to this action, the water is pumped into the required place. There are some important hints to notice. So when this crank mechanism with the help of a single stroke per one revolution will be known as single acting reciprocating pump. The two delivery strokes are present, then it will be called as double acting reciprocating pump. The comparison between centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump is present over here. The major application of the pumps are, first one, oil and energy sector. It helps to pump the crude oil, slurry, mud and also used by the refinery works. The second one, industrial and fire production industry, whereas heating and ventilation, boiler feed application, air conditioning, pressure boosting and fire protection sprinkler systems uses the pump. The third part is waste management, agriculture and manufacturing purpose. Here, wastewater processing plant, municipal industries, drainage, gas processing, irrigation system and flood protection system uses the pump. Last one is pharmaceutical, chemical and food industry. For producing the paints, processing the hydrocarbons, petrochemical works, sugar refining, etc. are uses the pump. In order to know the exact performance of the pump, we have to clear about unit assessment. The first one is pump capacity. Q equal to volume of liquid delivered by the pump per unit time, usually mentioned by meter cube per second, where Q is directly proportional to the rotational speed of the particular pump. Second one, total developed head. H equal to the difference of discharge and suction pressure. The pump head usually represents the net work done on unit rates of a liquid in passing from inlet of the pump to the discharge of the pump. In common, there are three heads usually mentioned in the pump. They are static head, velocity head, and friction head. Third one is system resistance. This is nothing but the sum of frictional head in resistance and total static head. The fourth parameter is hydraulic power, generally known as liquid horsepower. P suffix H equal to Q into HD minus HS into rho into G into 10 to the power of minus 3. Whereas PH is hydraulic power in terms of kilowatts, Q equal to pump capacity, HD and HS are the discharge head and suction head in meter, rho equal to density of the particular fluid, G equal to acceleration due to the gravity. The next parameter is pump soft power. P is generally calculated with the help of motor input power and efficiency of the motor for the existing load. The next parameter, pump efficiency. It is generally mentioned as the useful work done by the pump divided by the power input given to the pump shaft. Next, we are going to discuss about parallel operating performance of the pump. The image represents two pumps are connected in parallel. Usually, this kind of configuration used to increase the volume of water or fluid delivered by the particular pump. The performance curve clearly indicates when a single pump used what is the volume delivered by the pump, whereas when two pumps are operating in parallel, what is the volume extended due to that particular configuration. So, the major thing is the total head is not changed, only the volume delivered is changed here. There are some important hints that we know before connecting two pumps in parallel. They are, the both pumps should be having same head, also it should run at the same speed and same diameter impeller must be used. The major drawback of this configuration is the two pump in parallel delivers the water which is lesser than 2 times of the flow rate of the particular single pump. This is due to the increment in the friction of particular piping. Next, we are going to see about series operating performance of the pump. The image represents two pumps are connected in series. The major reason the pumps are connected in series is to increase the total head delivered by the particular pump, whereas the volume remains unchanged. The performance curve of the pumps operating in series clearly indicates that a single pump produces the lesser amount of total head, whereas two pumps together can increase the total head from the point A to the point B. The performance curve clearly indicates that total head is increased than the single pump. Also, the volume of the particular pump remains unchanged. There are some important points we have to notice before connecting two pumps in series. The first one is, both pumps must have the same width impeller and both pumps should run at the same speed. Also, the second pump must be stronger than the first pump, whereas high pressure mechanical seal compulsorily required in the second pump due to increment in the pressure. Also, both pumps should be filled with the liquid before starting, and always the second pump is started after the first pump. Next, we are going to discuss about energy saving in pumps and pumping systems. The first one is maintenance. Improper maintenance lowers the pump system efficiency, also causes pumps to wear out more quickly and increases the cost. There are particular points to be noticed in maintenance. They are replacement of worn impellers, especially if it is casting or semi-solid applications. Second thing is bearing inspection and repair. Also, proper lubrication replacement should be done annually or semi-annually. Next thing is inspection and replacement of packing seals. Following that, inspection and replacement of mechanical seal also important. The alignment of the pump and motor to be checked and supervised periodically. The second thing is monitoring. Monitoring in conjunction with operations and maintenance can be used to detect the problems and determine the solutions to create a more efficient system, which generally includes wear monitoring, vibration analysis, pressure and flow monitoring, current or power monitoring, differential head and temperature rise across the pump, and distribution system inspection for scaling or contaminant buildup. The next thing we are going to discuss about the control. The objective of any control strategy is to shut off the unwanted pump or to reduce the load of a particular pump. The recent advancement in technologies helps to control the pump remotely. The following circuit shows the automatic shutdown of the particular pump with the help of a basic controller. Also, there are certain applications of GSM, ZigBee and SCADA modules are helping in this process. Next thing is reduction of demand. With the help of holding tanks, we can equalize the flow over the production cycle. Also, we can enhance the energy efficiency and pump capacity can be reduced further. Also, the total head requirements can be reduced by lowering the process static pressure and minimizing the elevation level from the suction tank to discharge tank. The next parameter is energy efficient pump. Usually, the pump efficiency may degrade 10% to 25% in its lifetime. Industry experts, however, point out that this degrading performance is not necessarily due to the age of the pump, but also can possibly be caused by changes in the process which may have caused a mismatch between the pump capacity and its operation. Also, we strongly recommend to use star-rated motors, which directly involves in the pump efficiency. The next parameter is proper pump sizing. The following table indicates when the total head increases, the pump motor size also increases with respect to the gallons per minute, or you can say the quantity of the particular water flow. Whereas proper pump sizing is necessary in order to achieve higher efficiency. Next parameter is using of multiple pumps. Whenever the load is varying, and particularly the static head dominated systems are used, the multiple pumps are recommended instead of using the single pump to do the operation. The next parameter is impeller trimming. The trimming reduces the impeller tip speed, which in turn reduces the amount of energy imparted to the pumped fluid. As a result, the pump's flow rate and pressure both decrease. The next parameter is using of adjustable speed drives. We know that variable frequency drives mostly used to reduce the energy consumption by the drive system. The similar kind of system can be employed to achieve the particular speed for the particular pump. So, whenever the flow rate to be controlled, the application of AST helps to do the same. There are certain miscellaneous items that we have to discuss. First one is avoiding the throttling valve and choosing the proper pipe size. Also replacing the conventional belt drive with the help of effective hub mounted pumps and precision castings and coating of the surface or polishing in order to avoid the corrosion and scaling problems. also improve the sealing in order to maintain the pressure.